Dear students, welcome to business studies class. In my previous class, you studied merits, demerits and types of partners. In this video, we are going to study types of partnership. Based on the duration, we have two types of partnership. First one, partnership at will. Second one, particular partnership. Based on liability, again we have two types of partnership. First one, limited liability partnership. Second one, unlimited liability partnership. So totally we have four types of partnership. Based on duration, again we have two types. Based on liability, we have two types of partnership. Now first one, classification on the basis of duration. On the basis of duration, we have two types of partnership. First one, partnership at will. Second one, particular partnership. Now look at the first one. What is partnership at will? This type of partnership exists at the will of the partners. It can continue as long as the partners want and is terminated when any partner gives a notice of withdrawal from the partnership to the firm. This means it is a voluntary. Anytime if any partner want to leave the partnership firm, then he can serve the notice, then he can take back his partnership. This is called partnership at will. A simple thing, that this type of partnership exists at the will of the partner. If the partner want to continue with the business, then he can continue. If the partner want to leave that partnership, then he has the right to leave the partnership. This is called partnership at will. Any point of time, anywhere, a partner, if he doesn't want to continue in the business concern, then he can leave the partnership. He can leave the firm. It's called partnership at will. Second one, particular partnership. The partnership formed for the accomplishment of a particular project. For example, for the construction of building or the bridges. This is to be carried on for a specified time period is called particular partnership. It dissolves. This means it ended automatically when the purpose for which it was formed is fulfilled or when the time duration expires. A simple one, particular partnership. We have formed one partnership just for finishing the one task. So me and my friend, we have formed on partnership for construction of a bridge or construction of a building. After construction of building or the bridge, our partnership agreement comes to an end. This is called particular partnership. We have formed that partnership just for one task. After finishing that task or work, then partnership agreement going to be ended. That is called particular partnership. I repeat now, on the basis of duration, we have two types of partnership. First one, partnership at will. Second one, particular partnership. In the partnership at will, partners, they can continue if they want, or they can leave the partnership if they don't want to continue in the firm. It is called partnership at will. In the particular partnership, we have formed one partnership just for achievement of one task or one activity. After finishing that work, then the partnership firm going to be terminated. It is called particular partnership. Move on to next slide. Now, classification on the basis of liability. Again, we have two types of partnership. First one, general partnership. Second one, limited partnership. In general partnership, the liability of partner is unlimited and joint. The partners enjoy right to participate in the management of the firm. Their acts are binding on each other as well as on the firm. This type of partnership firm, the registration is optional, not compulsory. The existence of the firm is affected by the death, renuncy, insolvency, or retirement of any partner. This is called general partnership. In this type of partnership, the partners, they introduce their capital, they participate in the management, then they have unlimited liability. They have unlimited liability. When you come to registration of this type of partnership firm, it is optional. Got the point now? This is called general partnership. In this type of partnership, liability of all the partner is unlimited. Liability of all the partner is unlimited. This is called general partnership. Second one, limited partnership. Now, in limited partnership, the liability of at least one partner is unlimited, whereas the rest may have limited liability. Such a partnership does not get terminated with the death, renuncy, or insolvency of limited partner. The limited partners don't enjoy the right of management. Registration of such a partnership is compulsory. When you come to limited partnership, if we have 10 partners in the partnership form, in this, one partner's liability should be unlimited. Rest may have limited liability. If we have 10 partners, one partner's liability is unlimited. Remaining 9 partners' liability is limited. One more thing is here. In this type of partnership, the partners, those who have limited liability, they don't have any right to participate in the management of the firm. Again, the registration of this type of partnership is compulsory. When you come to general partnership, registration was optional. When you come to limited partnership, registration of partnership is compulsory. This is the second one. So now we have studied 4 types of partnership on the basis of duration, 2 types of partnership, partnership at will, then second one, particular partnership. On the basis of liability, first one, general partnership, second one, limited partnership. Now, move on to next concept, partnership deed. What is partnership deed? The written agreement which specifies the terms and conditions that govern the partnership is called the partnership deed. It's agreement. As we know, in the partnership we have more than 2 persons. When we have more persons, there is a chance of difference in opinion. When there is a difference in opinion, there may be the room for clash or dispute. To settle this type of dispute or problems in future, we should have the agreement. It is called partnership deed. It is agreement which specifies the terms and conditions. This is called partnership deed. Now, what are the content of partnership deed? Our partnership deed or partnership agreement should contain following items. First one, name of the firm, then nature of the business and location of the business, then duration of the business, investment made by each partner, distribution of profits and losses, duties and obligation of the partners, salaries and withdrawals of the partners, terms governing admission, retirement and expulsion of a partner, interest on capital and interest on drawings, procedure for dissolution of the firm, preparation of accounts and their auditing, then method of solving the dispute. So these are all the contents it should be added in the partnership deed or in the agreement. In simply, it is the agreement among the partners. It is called partnership deed. Move on to next one. Here, it is the partnership deed of J&K company. Here we have five partners: Gelani J, Dalwadi Jugal, Thakkar Kishan, Solanki Kunjan, Shah Krishna. So five partners are here. Then they made partnership deed on 6th day of March 2013. What's the name of the firm? J&K. Then the firm came into effect 1st day of April 2013. It is the one specimen of partnership deed. Then we have some content or rules and regulations regarding partnership deed. Look at the fifth point, last sentence of fifth point. All the partners' salary is not exceeds more than 25,000 per month. That means total salary should not exceed more than 25,000 partner salary. So then look at the seventh one. When the partner withdraw money from the firm, it is called drawings, then they have to pay interest of 6% per annum on withdrawing amount. So this is a conditions or the content of partnership deed. Then we have 18 content. At the end, then all the partners should put their sign. This is a specimen of one partnership deed. Now, next concept, registration of a partnership firm. Now, what's the meaning of registration of partnership firm? Registration of a partnership firm means the entering of the firm's name along with the relevant prescribed particulars in the register of the firms kept with the registrar of firms. It provides conclusive proof of existence of a partnership firm. Simple thing, registration means entering the firm's name in the register book of a registrar. It is called registration of partnership firm. It is optional for a partnership firm to get registered. As I said, if our partnership is general partnership, then it is optional. If our partnership is limited partnership firm, then it is compulsory to get registered. Now, in case a firm does not get registered, it is deprived of many benefits. Now, what's the loss? What's the disadvantages? If our firm is not registered, then what are all the problems or what are all the, what do you call, limitations? First one, a partner of an unregistered firm cannot file a suit against the firm or other partners. If our firm is not registered, then a partner, he can't lodge any complaint against his firm or on other partners. It is the limitation. Second one, the firm cannot file any case on third party. If our firm is not registered, then we can't file or we can't lodge any case against third party. Third problem or limitation, the firm cannot file a case against the partners. If our firm is not registered, then that case our firm cannot file a case or our firm cannot lodge a case against the other partner. This is the problems or the limitations when or if our firm is not registered. Got the point? If our firm is not registered, then we have some limitations. First one, a partner cannot lodge any file against the firm or on other partners. He can't file a case. Second one, the firm cannot file a case against third party. Third one, a firm cannot file a case against the partner. This is the problems or limitations if our firm is not registered. Now, what is the procedures for the registration? The first one, submission of application in the prescribed form to the registrar of firms. The application should contain following particulars. So in the application, there are some particulars. First one, name of the firm, then location of the firm, name of other places where the firm carries on business, the date when each partner joined the firm, names and addresses of the partner, then duration of the partnership. Then this application should be signed by all the partner. So the application is duly filled first. It's the first one, first step. Second step, deposit the required fees with the registrar of the firm. We have to pay some fees for the firm's registration. Third one, the registrar after approval will make an entry in his book in the register of the firms and will subsequently issue a certificate of registration. After registration of our firm, then we get the certificate. These are three procedures. First one, what do you call? Fill the application. Second one, deposit required fees. Then send or give our application to the registrar of the firm for the registration. It's the three procedures. So look at this slide. Look at this slide. What is registration of a partnership firm? Registration of a partnership firm means entering of a firm's name in the register of the firm kept with the registrar. It is not obligatory, it is optional. Then look at the procedure. First one, submit an application. Second one, file the partnership deed. Third one, pay the fees. Fourth one, approval of the application. But in textbook, in your first textbook, you have only three steps. Okay. Now, this is one registration certificate. Just a specimen. Just observe this. The Indian Partnership Act of 1932. The partnership firm is registered under Partnership Act of 1932. It is from Mumbai. Okay, Mumbai. Now look at one more certificate of registration of Karnataka. So both are just a specimen of रजिस्ट्रेशन सर्टिफिकेट। ओके, थैंक यू, सी नेक्स्ट वीडियो।